of someone very special I would like you to meet. This, hello, this is Era. Yes, she is my daughter. She's 2 weeks old today, aren't you? Yeah, what a great time to be born in the world. So I thought today we'd have a, big yawn. So I thought today we'd have a video with a little bit of a difference, and we would do a bit of a vlog together, our first video together, taking some photos. So I have a bit of a setup in the background. I will clear up at this point. I'm not really a newborn-y photographer, am I? No. I have limited idea of what I'm doing, so we're just gonna really have a bit of a play and see if I can get some nice photos to treasure this time. Because right now, she is a very content, quiet little lady, aren't you? Yeah? No big temper tantrums, no big crying fits. And I'm sure all that is gonna change at some point. So I'm gonna put you down here. So, for clarity, before we kick this off, setup, pretty straightforward. This is just the table with the dog's bed as a cushion, and then just a cheap woolen blanket thrown over the top of it, just to disguise that fact. We have one key light through a softbox, which is the newer S400N, which I will say now, if you are after a studio light, do not buy those because they are shite. Honestly, they are the most irritating, annoying piece of equipment that I've ever had the misfortune of using. They're just constantly firing off for no apparent reason whatsoever. I've got a pair of them and they both do the same thing. I also have a flash on a stand just behind the table here pointing towards a backdrop, which is really going to do two things. One, it's going to give me the opportunity of putting a bit of separation, a bit of colour into, a bit of light onto the background. So I can either go with jet black if I want, or I can mix it up a little bit. The second more important thing it's doing is it's triggering the key light, because I'm shooting with the Sony a7 III. It doesn't have a flash sync port to be able to tether straight into a studio light. So I've got the Godox X1T trigger, which is firing the Godox flash. It's a 685. I can't remember which one it is, but it's the fairly budget one. Flash on the back. So the idea is when I take the picture, this triggers the flash on the background, but it's also going to trigger the key light. And then I have a reflector on the side here, which is just going to help try and fill in some of the shadow. Now I'm going to try and dabble with an ND filter on this one as well, because I want a kind of a very shallow depth of field on a face. But this light is just too bright. Even on that's on minimum power now, but it's just far too bright. So I've got a ND64 static filter that might take it a little bit too dark, but it's all I've got at the minute. You up a bit more. Yeah, though. So we were using the Tamron 2875. Now we're gonna go with the trusty 8518. I think somebody might have had enough. Yeah? You had enough? Well, that explains why you're in a grumpy mood. So I think that's going to be it for this video, guys. Like I said, it wasn't anything particularly special. It was more just I was doing some photos of little Miss here and thought I'd share what I was doing. And you know, if there are any newborn photographers out there who could give me a bit more of a pointer as to how to get some nicer photos, it would be much appreciated. So that's it for this video, guys. As always, if you have any questions or queries, the comment box is down below. While you're down there, if you enjoyed this video and you haven't already, please consider hitting the like and subscribe button, and hopefully I will see you in the next video. Are you sucking on my finger?
Yeah.
Ah-ha! Come on, let's go get you sorted.